To summarize, L'Odyssée de Sven is about a man who's dissatisfied with his life in Stockholm as a mill worker and dreaming of adventure and something more important, a more important life, takes a mining contract in the Arctic archipelago of Spitsbergen, now called Svalbard. And shortly thereafter, his mining career is cut short when his face is horribly mutilated in an avalanche, a mining accident. And feeling self-conscious, understandably, he removes himself to an even more isolated spot, a fjord in the remote northern part of the archipelago, where he spends most of the rest of his life. And that's the basic summary. The question is about how important nature is in my novel. It's crucial. It's one of the main characters, I would say. I come from a background of nature writing, which I understand is a different connotation in France than in the États-Unis. But I begin almost every project I do with setting, location, and I have to visit, if at all possible, take many notes, smell it, look at the birds, get a feeling for the place, and so I can evoke it and make it real. And a place, as you said, such as Spitsbergen is both austere and grandiose. Those aspects of its character are the through line of Sven's life. When I was there in Spitsbergen for an artist residency, I happened to visit the hut of the real Stockholm Sven. And I was given very little information at the time, which was basically what I told you about him coming from Stockholm and being mutilated in a mining accident. And that was really all I knew. And so for the entirety of the writing project, that's all I had to work with. I fictionalized the rest. So it was just a tiny kernel of historical basis. After the fact, I was able to learn a little bit more about the real Sven, whose surname I changed. And he led a very different life, a much shorter life, as it turned out, from the Sven of the book. I thought this would just be a novel of loneliness. I'm glad it wasn't. I think it was a richer, warmer novel for having other characters in it, and less austere. But yes, the essential characters of his life are a Scottish geologist named Charles McIntyre, who forms Sven's social and cultural education. He's a reader, he listens to music, he cares about the world, and he helps form Sven into a fully formed human being, as does his friend Tapio, the Finnish socialist trapper, who helps Sven learn how to survive. The key thing, because Sven is not the most competent hunter or trapper. He needs help, he needs guidance and expertise. So McIntyre and Tapio are key, and then of course we have Sven's sister back home in Stockholm, and eventually Sven's niece, who forms a key part of Sven's story later on. I would only say thank you from the bottom of my heart, but to those who haven't yet, I would say not to expect a manly adventure story, or not to hope for that, because that's not really what it is. It's a story about, it has humor, it has warmth, there's love. It's about finding community. Maybe there's a few adventures, I guess I would call them misadventures along the way, but it's not that kind of story.